All right, what is up, guys? Welcome back to another patch notes breakdown video. It's gonna be for the Paladins RWBY update. Technically a mid-season update, but man, it sure does not feel like it at all. If anything, it's probably the worst update we've gotten pretty much the entire year, apart from skins. Before we hop into this, though, I know there's a lot of new people that are actually looking to get into the game. And if you don't know what Paladins is, or if you're gonna be new to the game, and if you happen to be hopping over to this game, this next patch, and somebody that follows RWBY and looking to get into the game just based off this collaboration, feel free to subscribe. We do a lot of Paladins videos over here. We do ranked stuff, Paladins ranked tips videos, stuff like that, with gameplay with the game, tier list, and we also stream the game quite a lot, at least like 2 or 3 times a week. So if you guys don't want to miss out on that, if you happen to be new to the game or new to the channel, feel free to subscribe. Would really appreciate it. I'm not gonna waste any more time though. Not gonna be too much on screen, so if you guys missed the patch notes or did not see the patch notes page yet, there's not gonna be too much else apart from just going off the patch notes. If you just want to tab out and listen to me talk, that'd be great. If you guys like these types of videos, let me know as well. Leaving likes, subscribing, sharing the video. You guys know the deal. Let's get right into this. We got a crossover pass for RWBY. Like I said, I've never really watched this series. I think I watched season one, maybe like halfway through, and then I got sidetracked and I never really came back to it. So, Smite had about the same thing. Smite had a collaboration with RWBY about 3 years ago. They had Weiss, Schnee, Freya, Ruby Rose, Thanatos, Terra, Yang, and then I think they had Amaterasu, Blake, Belladonna. So they had the same thing. And they actually had recolors with theirs as well. They had like I think two recolors for Ruby Rose, and I think a real recolor for, I think it was for Blake or something. They had some recolors as well with their battle pass, but I don't know. We'll find out who has the best battle pass. I think actually Smite. Like I hate Smite and I hate how Smite is currently, and I fucking hate Smite currently, and it's not fun at all. But back then, I think Smite actually had the better battle pass. Just assuming off right now, and what we got. Like there's, I'll talk about it real quick as we go on. It doesn't show the price, which is really weird. It does not show the price at all here, which I'm assuming it's probably going to be either 750 crystals or like 800. So if you guys, hopefully you guys have enough crystals to shell out for this, but it is going to have all the skins. So you're going to have all these skins, 4 skins in the event pass this time, instead of just like 2 or having half of them locked behind Prime Gaming, which they did learn. I'll give Hi-Rez a 1-up here and I'll give them a huge plus. They learned from last time and from the Monster Cat Battle Pass that locking half of the skins that people want and the best skins that everybody wanted behind Prime Gaming was a bad idea. Whether or not they do it in the future, I don't know. They probably still will. But at least for this patch, they learned their lesson and they gave us the entire battle pass of all the skins that everybody wanted. There you go. There's a huge plus, and that's a huge W for them because they actually learned their lesson, at least for one patch. They'll probably go and do the same thing later this year or sometime next year still. But at least for right now, at least with this collab, they never did. No Prime Gaming garbage. There you go. Instant unlock, we got Ruby Rose, Fora, Yang, Amani is a level 9, level 19, Sati, and then Weiss, Schnee, Furia at level 29. If you guys missed the update show, I also streamed live reactions and discussion during the update show earlier. If you guys missed that, go check it out. It should be live on the channel right now. I'll leave a link to that at the end of this video, so you guys go check it out yourself. But if you guys missed the update show, go check it out. They showed all these skins in the update show. My only problem with these skins is that they don't really fit. The only one that kind of fits is, or 100% fits, is Vora being Ruby Rose. The rest of these skins don't really fit the characters. They really don't. And another thing that we really noticed too on the update show is like they don't even move like the actual characters from the anime or the show. They still move like the actual characters from in-game. Like Yang moves to exactly like how Amani moves, and it doesn't look good at all. Furia moves and she floats, but for some reason Weiss is not walking and she's still floating exactly like Furia, and it looks really weird. I don't know if it's actually just unfinished and it's not supposed to be that way, but they just needed something to show us during the update show, or if that's how it's supposed to be. I don't know. Same with Sati. Like Sati walks really weird, just like Sati, but it does not look good on Blake Belladonna at all. Like she walks really weird and does not fit her at all. And the only thing they really miss with these skins, which like I said, I'm not sure if they're fully finished or not. If they aren't, then it might be changed during the live patch of the PTS, but they missed the entire walking animations for all these skins. The only one that looks natural, like by default, is Vora, because Vora looks like Ruby anyways. They're really similar and they're almost identical, and probably the best pairing if you were to put two characters together. But like these other ones, Saphiria floating being the exact same as Weiss, that her floating doesn't look good at all. Imani's natural walk with Yang looks awful, and then Salty's normal walk with Blake looks really bad too. It just looks really off for these other three characters. I don't know if that's intentional or if that's just laziness. I don't know. But then again, you can say, well, you're only going to be playing him in first person. There's no longer any third person, so you won't be seeing that anyways if you buy the skins yourself. So that's another argument people are going to have since they took away third person a long time ago. But the people on my team are sure going to see me walking like a douche, walking all weird. Got some death stamps, some cosmetics, whatever. I mean, I don't really care. I'll never use any of this stuff. Those of you guys that are fans of the series and everything like that, you guys might, but I'll never use any of this type of stuff. We got a death stamp that looks pretty good. 3D spray, I'll never use. A cool, okay looking loading frame. Not the best loading frame we've gotten. I think the corrupted one we got this patch, the live patch, is better. We got a Zwei. I'm not sure what Zwei is. I think that's the dog. I think Zwei is the dog from the series. I think there's a dog. Because I remember Smite having something like that too. Ruby Rose is probably the best avatar right here. Probably if there was one to use, I think it would be this one, at least for me. I like that one. Got some Trials of the Realm. 300 crystals. Man, you can't even buy a damn event pass anymore with the Trials of the Realm. What's going on? Six time booster, skins, gold, whatever. Got an avatar, animated avatar, sprays. They got an emote for Rey that looks pretty good. Probably the best thing out of the Trials of the Realm is this anime or this emote. Booing or boring. Boring, whatever. For those of you guys that still play Rey. MVP pros for Vora looks pretty good. Probably the two best thing. That's legit all of value. That is legit it that looks like that. That'll actually be good. Apart from crystals, you got two MVP poses out of the Trials of the Realm next patch, guys. Man, some real good content to grind for Paladins. You don't give us any content barely to begin with this patch for a mid-season update, and we got nothing for the Trials of the Realm either. Apart from some gems or some crystals, and then two MVP poses to grind for. There you go. That's nice. You think they would have gave us more actual good stuff to grind for because they're lacking on content. I don't know. Limited time modes, I don't care. I don't care about limited time modes. They're bringing back test maps, though. This is like the biggest one. They're bringing back test maps, which is really cool. That is probably the best limited time mode, but the problem with it is you're not going to be getting EXP. So why would I play test maps if I'm not getting experience points? Doesn't make sense. Here we go again, guys. Here we go again. Now these are extra. These are all extra skins that you can buy if you want for direct purchase, or they're locked behind a chest for like I think 400 crystals per chest roll, and they're probably going to be like 800 or 900 for a direct purchase if you just want the skin itself without having to roll a chest. I don't know. I don't care. I really don't care. Like these skins look really good. This one doesn't fit Corvus at all. This looks more like a Fernando skin or something else. It doesn't fit Corvus at all. I'm sorry. It looks really weird. But the Ceres one looks good, but I'm just sick of Ceres getting skins. I know the last skin she had was for the Radiant Stars Battle Pass, which was a while back already, but like look at how many skins Ceres has compared to a lot of the other characters in the game. She shouldn't get another skin for at least another 2 years. Why we're getting another Ceres skin is just beyond me. It doesn't make sense. Like I know why they gave all the other girls in this patch, like Salty, Furia, and all these other skins, champion skins, because you had to make it match the what you were trying to make it match, and that's the characters that fit the best. Thus, they're getting skins. That made sense. That's why they did it. I understand that, but at least for this, like Ceres didn't need a skin. I'm sorry, we didn't need another Ceres skin. I really don't think we need that. And same with Corvus. Corvus just got a skin for Halloween. He just got a vampire skin a little bit while back, like half a year ago, for Halloween. Why do we need another Corvus skin? I don't understand. got a new Lilith skin. It is a star, it's pretty much like a Star Sister theme. It's gonna be locked behind a chest and then a direct purchase. So if you guys have 800 crystals or like 900 crystals laying around and you guys want this skin, by all means go buy it. It looks really good though. Like if anything, I think this is actually, apart from like the RWBY skins, the Vora and the Weiss Shi skin, other two look eh. But apart from those two, I think this is probably the other best one. If you're looking to actually get a skin, the others are, I wouldn't say they're really worth it, unless you're like a really fan of the series of like the RWBY stuff. Finally, they learned, guys, they're giving us a shitty recolor. They're giving us a recolor for the Prime Gaming reward instead of locking behind all the skins that people want behind Prime Gaming. They finally learned for one patch. Wow, it's crazy. They finally took our feedback. Battle Pass 2020 chests, who cares? Here's another thing that this doesn't make any sense. Here's where I'm saying to you guys, like, here's the theme for this entire patch so far. Though up to this point, like, we have a really solid amount of content up until this point, which is just mainly an event pass, and then like three extra skins being Corvus, Ceres, and Lilith. No other skins, by the way, too. Like, where is a skin for like Pip? Pip hasn't had a skin in 4 years. Shaolin hasn't had a skin in almost 4 years. Makoa hasn't had a skin in 4 years. There's a bunch of other champions in the game that haven't had a skin in forever, too. You think they would have thrown us a bone and give us a skin for those? No gold skins. Not a single gold skin at all. No golden Zin. No golden Eevee. No golden anything else. No gold skins at all. Another patch with no gold skins. That's one less thing we have. I think the entire theme for this patch, and especially for like a mid-season update, which is going to be releasing it towards the end of June. I think the last week of June, right before the July 4th. I think the week before that, it's going to be releasing. So, for like a mid-season patch, this is a really lackluster patch. Usually the mid-season patches are like the best patches, and they have the most changes, like balance changes and the most content, apart from like a season launch patch at a start of a season. This has nothing. I'm telling you guys right now, especially from a content creator standpoint, this patch is going to be really, really fucking boring. It really is. We have no new champion. We have nothing else, really. We have an okay amount of balance changes. But even then, for a mid-season patch, we don't have nearly enough stuff for at least like balance changes. And considering how bad some of these balance changes are, once we get into them here in a little bit, like some of these balance changes are just make you scratch your head and ask yourself, why do we have an AOC like Assembly of Champions representatives? And why is this even in the game? And why is this even being implemented or changed for like half of these balance changes? Because they're just so awful. Looking at them a lot more. We're getting a Trade District rework, guys. Trade District's getting a visual update. Who cares? Who cares? You are updating a TDM map that is like legit like 6 years old that barely anybody plays anyways, apart from people that are just playing TDM. If you're gonna waste this time on visually updating a map, why don't you just give us an entirely new map? Where is the new map? You guys promised a new map halfway through the season, which is right now, it's mid-season. You guys said at the start of the season during this the was it during the Hi-Rez Expo or the Hi-Rez Showcase, you guys had a new map lined up for us, and it was going to be released towards the middle of the season, towards the middle of the year. We're at the mid-season mark. Where's the new Siege map? Where's it at? It's gone. No, it's not here. Again, like I said, this entire patch is severely lacking content. And apart from like maybe like four skins, I guess maybe four skins for the event pass, and a small amount of balance changes that actually do anything and are actually relevant and actually make sense, this is going to be a boring patch. I feel bad for you guys, and I feel bad for myself because I gotta stream this shit and I gotta try to make do with this shit for 2 months before we get another patch afterward, with barely anything to actually sink our teeth into. No new champion, no new map, no new nothing. Instead, we're getting Trade District reworks and visual updates. Whatever, who cares? Who cares? Here's another cool thing, though. Here's a positive. Expanded the custom game options, so we got some really cool custom game options now. Ultimate cooldown, starting credits, damage amplifier, movement speed, global cooldown, disabled health regen. It's really cool stuff. More of this, More of custom game quality of life changes and quality of life options and extra options for custom games. Less TDM map reworks unless you're going to give us an entirely new map. Thank you. Also, where are the sound bug? Where are the sound bug reworks? Like, there was something about the sound bugs, I think, on the update show. That they said they're seriously looking into the sound bugs. I don't know if any of you guys have been playing the current patch, the sound bugs. The sound with the games is entirely screwed up. There's entire champions that are just, like, silent with certain skins. Sky has, like, two skins that are just completely silent. She has no sound for any of her Monster Cat skins. Vaatu, like, half of his skins are completely silent. There are a number of champions in the game that have, like, half of their audio or alts that have no sound. It's just a lot of stuff's really broken. And they first now acknowledge that they're working on the sound bugs now. And it's been a thing for about a month. I can tell you right now, like, any other game would have already had the sound bugs already hot fixed and already patched if it was not a high-risk game. I truly believe that they do not actually know how to actually fix their own game, which is a really scary thing. If they can't fix sound bugs, what other serious shit that is bound to go wrong with this game that they can't fix is going to happen in the future? It is really scary to think about. It really is. If they can't fix some simple sound bugs that just ruin the game for a month. Here we go. Item store auto buys. We finally got this re-enabled and disabled as they wish during a match. Finally. It's still bugged. Alright, well, apologize for that, guys, but randomly I was recording and my recording cut off and it actually ended up crashing, so I don't know how much I actually recorded, but I'm going to record for where I think I left off, which I think was with auto-buy. I think I was talking about auto-buy, like how this is not a actual fix, it's just a quality of life change. They never fixed actually the auto-buy bug if you crash and come back, or there's a bug or something with it right now. I don't know. Undefined ability order. Who's going to use this? You can change your abilities now in the HUD. You can change where they are. Who's going to use that? I don't know about you guys, but that is after all these years of just having the abilities in the same spot on the HUD when you're playing, I think I'm going to be really confused if I change anything around. It's there now, though. I guess it's there. If anybody wants to use it, they're updating the free roster changes. I'm not going to talk about that very much. We got a bunch of balance I need to get into, because this is here with the meat and potatoes of this patch. And this is where I'm going to start bitching and complaining. So if you do not like when somebody just drives something into the ground and just bashes something, there's going to be a lot of that in this. Because a lot of this shit is either AOC suggestions that are more than likely got through and influenced some of these balance changes, and they don't make any sense. And a lot of these balance changes don't make any sense at all, and are just somehow worse than before, which we'll talk about. Or there's stuff that's not even included here. There's a number of things that aren't even included in this balance patch that should have been included and are going to be another thing that we just have to deal with next patch. That is just garbage to play against. Mainly stuff like Terminus, Sati, Lex not being nerfed. There's a bunch of other stuff as well. Dev commentary. Here's a new thing, guys. Every single killing blow card now is getting reworked into an elimination card, which is huge. Only once, there's a few cards with Lex and Tyra that aren't going to be changed, but apart from that, every single card that was activated on a killing blow is going to now be procced on an elimination instead. The only, like, the two champions I see, like, that are going to be getting really buffed by this, I guess maybe Lex. There's some cards with Lex that were on Killing Blow only that are probably getting reverted or getting changed. I'm not 100% sure, though. So don't quote me on that. I'm not 100% sure. But, like, the ones that I think are going to be getting buffed the most out of this are Buck, which is going to be a huge buff because most of his cards rely on you getting kills right now, at least in the current patch. Once that gets changed to eliminations, that's going to be a huge buff for him. Going to be a lot more steamrolly, and he's going to be a lot more easier to play and actually do stuff with. I still don't think he's going to be crazy good, but it's going to be a pretty good buff in the right direction, just kind of quality of life change. And then Leon. Leon, which is crazy already. She's insanely good already, and she's just going to be getting better now since she doesn't actually have to kill anything to get full resets on her entire cast of cooldowns. So there might be more champions too that I'm just not thinking of. Let me know in the comments down below. Items, here we go, guys. This is where it doesn't make sense. This is where it does not make sense. The real problem with the items in the game right now is there are some champions that are better than others. And the real thing that right now is there's like the two best items in the game pretty much are Haven and Veteran. If you're usually most games as like a second or even like your third or fourth item, every single game, apart from like your two other essential items, which could be like Kronos, Wrecker, and a few other things from a lot of the other champions, like your last two items are going to be Haven and Veteran almost every single game. These are two of the best items in the game right now, and they're being buffed for whatever fucking reason. Why does Veteran need to be buffed? It could be fine if they gave us a price increase, which was fine, but why did they need to buff both of these items? I'm just sitting here like I'm watching the patch notes show, and I'm just scratching my head, and I'm like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Like, why are they buffing these items? They're buffing this shit from 5.5 up to 6 to 12 to 18, but they're going to increase the cost. It doesn't do anything. Increasing the cost would have been good if they did not buff the item. But now they're buffing the item again, so it doesn't make sense and it doesn't matter. These two items are still going to be the best two items in the game, and they're going to be must-pick items. That is the real problem right now with the game too. And then with these items being picked, it kind of throws off damage numbers and everything around the game. Characters that aren't supposed to be really tanky are getting a lot more tanky because they take less damage and have more health, and they're more difficult to kill. The characters in the game that really don't do that much damage to begin with, such as like Maeve, and there's a few other ones that don't really do that much damage to begin with, now have to actually waste cooldowns and try to land even more shots and do more damage when their numbers really aren't the greatest to begin with on targets that have even more DR and reduced damage and more health now. So it makes those type of characters that don't really do that much damage or kind of struggle with damage numbers and mainly just like mobility, just have other stuff about them that makes them good, but don't really have like raw damage numbers, kind of struggle with these items being buffed and with how good these items already are. And it's going to be 10 times worse next patch with those type of characters. Stuff like Tiberius, Maeve, there's a few other ones too. There's a lot of other champions that are really struggling right now. There's like a handful of champions that are just really struggling because everybody buys Haven and everybody buys Veteran, and they don't really do that much damage to begin with, and everybody's just tanky as fuck, and you just get 1v1 traded, or you don't do enough damage to actually matter, and you just fall off, apart from like the first 5 minutes of the game. I just don't understand. Maybe in the PTS they'll revert this. I don't know. It's just so fucking stupid though, and it's probably one of the worst changes and the most questionable changes out of this entire patch. Guardian being buffed is fine. Guardian's garbage, and it can only be built on a limited amount of characters anyways. I still don't even think it's worth picking. Like, they're buffing two of the best items in the game anyways. Like, why would you pick Guardian over Haven or Veteran? I still don't see a reason why you would even pick this. Anyways. Illuminate's getting buffed. Wow, so instead of picking a tier 2 of Illuminate almost out of spawn, now I have to wait a little bit longer. Whatever. It's a buff to the stealth champions. Man, I can't wait to play against Sky more, because Sky is already really fun to play against, especially in your mid to low tier ranked games, and just have her. I can maybe be able to deal with her, but she'll just farm the shit out of my team. The ones that don't know how to play the game, they'll she'll just farm those, and that'll be even worse next patch. They already don't buy Illuminate to begin with. Here's another cool item change. They reworked Provision into Lethality. It gives you movement speed now for 2.5 seconds after getting an elimination. I don't know how this is actually gonna even be good. I really don't. It can maybe be good on like your other type of characters. I think this would be actually better on like tanks, actually. It would be pretty damn good on tanks and melee supports. I don't think you would actually even really want to run this on like your DPS champions just because you have so many other items that are just better than movement speed anyways. Mainly for stuff that doesn't really have that much mobility, just give you some extra speed. I don't know. There's maybe a few, like a handful of maybe flanks and maybe DPS that don't have really that much mobility that can get some extra movement speed that can help them. I don't know. But then again, are you going to pass up items like Veteran and Haven and Nimble and Mastery Riding and Morale Boost and Wrecker for lethality? Probably not. Androxus. Here is where the AOC strikes again. This is not what Andro needed. This isn't what Andro needed. This is not what Andro needed at all. Revolver. The cursed revolver talent has now been put into his base kit. Fire an automatic revolver dealing 550 damage every 0.5 seconds, has a max ammo of 6, and is fully effective up to 50 units. Cursed revolver has been put into his base kit. Okay. And now they're giving us talents. This is something from the AOC. I know somebody from the AOC was actually recommending this, and it happened to go through, or at least most of it did. Cursed revolver got reworked. Your revolver applies an effect that lasts for 2 seconds, dealing damage every 0.15 seconds. That increases the damage the longer it remains on the enemy. Max damage per hit is 50. This might be one of the worst reworked talents I think we've ever gotten, right alongside Crackshot. This, pretty much what this is, at least from what I'm thinking it is a flank version of Crackshot. That is what this is. The new reworked awful garbage crack shot that Strix currently has. I think that's what this is. Are you fucking kidding me? If you are on the AOC and you are recommending this shit, please fucking step down. I think we're better off without AOC reps. I really do. Like the AOC, any of the balance the AOC put through is usually garbage, and it actually makes the game worse. It really does. Like, I'm pretty sure, I'm not exactly 100% sure who it actually was that sent this through and suggested this, but I remember seeing this somewhere, something similar to this, where Cursed Revolver gets put into Andro's base kit, and we get a reworked talent. If they wanted to rework a talent, why didn't they just bring back Darkstalker? Darkstalker, which was a talent that got taken away when there was four talents. Why didn't they just bring that back? That would have been way better than this. Garbage. So now Andro, instead of having one good talent and two other useless talents, now he has three talents that are all garbage. There you go. Real good balance changes. Real good AOC feedback and real good balance changes for everybody involved. So if anything, I think actually Andro got worse. Or at least how it seems here. At least of how it seems. I don't know. I'll have to wait until the PTS gets released and see how everybody's playing him in the PTS. And if he actually gets pushed alive like this, I don't know. But at least from what it seems like, just reading this and kind of seeing how this actually is and how this is supposed to be, I think he'll actually be worse than he currently is. Actually, even more useless, which is it's the problem with Andro is right now is he has one good talent, and the other two of his talent, which is God Slayer and Defiant Fist, are just garbage. He needs a power shift from Cursed Revolver into his other talents. Make his other talents viable and as an alternate playstyle. Make Defiant Fist usable again, and make God Slayer worth playing over Cursed Revolver. At least make them at least justifiable playing over that talent. That is the one problem he has right now. Not to entirely remove it and put it into his base kit and then give us a useless talent. That's not what we needed. Stupid balance changes. Leave it to the AOC. I don't know. You guys are worthless. I'm sorry. You guys' suggestions are just awful. If that it was from the AOC, like most people are saying it was, whoever suggested it needs to step down. I'm sorry. Garbage. Generate 1% all charge after hitting at least one enemy with Defiance. Okay, whatever. And then Vengeance, instead of it's gonna be a healing type of card now. Who cares? Beta La Bomba, guys. I can tell you right now, these changes are gonna do nothing. These changes do nothing to Beta La Bomba. She is still the most buggiest character in the game, and her reload completely kills her. She has 10% increased reload speed, but instead of that, they should just make it so you reload an entire clip instead of having to reload every single grenade. That is her main problem. Until her bugs and that gets fixed, she's going to be garbage and one of the worst, most irrelevant characters the game never needed at all. You guys want to know what happens when you want to play Betty La Bamba? You look at Betty La Bamba and I say play Dredge because Dredge does the exact same thing and he's 10 times better. There you go. no reason for even to even be in the game. She is a waste of a champion and continues to be. And the most buggy champion still. She's still the most buggy champion in the game. Bomb King. Decreased midair accuracy. That's cool. Increased your movement speed. That's really cool. Overall, some small buffs. Some small card buffs that are decent, I guess. I'm not sure. I don't really play too much Bomb King. Mainly kind of a PC thing, but hopefully, and maybe he'll be a little bit better. Buck, Stomping Ground, reduced all cooldowns now after getting an elimination. That's huge. That's his best card. We'll see how that plays out. I still don't think he's going to be that good, though. Like, the real problem with Buck is he just has no long, mid to long range damage. You have to be right in somebody's face to do his entire damage. And it's really difficult to do that when Haven and Veteran are getting buffed again. So you can be right in somebody's face, but they're going to have more health and they're going to have more damage reduction to begin with, even this next patch afterward. So it's going to even still be difficult to kill stuff. Even worse, probably. So even with this buff, I think it's going to be kind of in the same spot because they're buffing Haven and Veteran again. Megaton. Megaton's getting reworked. So having an actual useful card that actually a lot of people actually use, now they're reworking it to a card that's actually garbage and nobody will actually use. I think this was actually an AOC suggestion too. Somebody on the AOC, or like a few people on the AOC, also suggested this. I don't know. I really don't know. I don't know about you guys, but if I was on the AOC and if I actually did get into the AOC, I would make changes to actually make the game better, not worse. Why are we taking a card that's already used and reworking a card that's actually already used and people are using into a card that's never going to be used at all with anything? So now you're taking one of Cassie's best cards and you're making it irrelevant for no reason. Because that makes a lot of sense, right? Oh, well, I don't like the knockback that Megaton does. Megaton has an annoying knockback. Well, there is an item in the game, you know, that's called resilience that prevents you from being knocked back if that really is a problem. Do you guys not know how to buy resilience out of the item shop? That you have to rework everything that has a small knockback or is a little annoying? There is an item in the item shop. I don't know if you guys realize. Apparently, the people on the AOC don't realize that. Corvus. Corvus is getting some weird changes. I don't know what these cards do. Let me know in the comments down below, like, what cards these are, because I'm off the top of my head, I'm not sure what cards these are. But some of his cards are getting nerfed, some of them are getting buffed. I'm not sure which ones these really are. The only one I think I know is, I think it's Grand Design. I think that's his extra healing card, I think. That's slightly getting nerfed. I don't even know why they're nerfing Corvus. I really don't. I think he's the most balanced, like one of the most balanced supports in the game. Like, why are we touching Corvus? Why are we touching Corvus when he's the most balanced he's ever been? He doesn't need anything changed about him at all right now. I don't understand. Dredge getting some buffs. Removed midair accuracy on both of his main fire and his harpoon, and then they're actually reducing the pre-fire time on his Kraken so you can land it at easier and faster. There you go, some nice buffs. There's a W. Good changes for Dredge. There we go. Drogo's getting a card that actually procs on elimination now. I don't know if it'll actually be good or not. We'll find out. Eevee getting some card reworks and some card changes just because of the elimination from killing Blow change. Mainly I think that'll probably be affected on PC because she's played a lot more on PC. And her Last Stand's getting nerfed for whatever reason, I don't know why. Incinerate's getting slightly buffed, and then Hot Pursuit no longer has an internal cooldown before this effect can activate again, so I don't know. Will we see Flank Nando back? I don't know. We'll find out. Furia, reduce the size of targeting cone. I don't know what that means. What does that mean? I wish they would clarify on this. Is that like the, like looking forward, like looking straight forward at my teammates from like side to side? Is that like the cone where I'm actually able to like, in like my POV, is that like actual like, it's like the amount of range I have to actually heal them within like a POV type of radius and like a cone radius of where I'm looking. Is that what that's supposed to mean? I can't really explain it that much. I'm not 100% sure. I wish they would clarify on that. Solar Blessing's going back to 3,000 health. Finally. Finally getting Solar Blessing back to where it was. At least somewhat where it was. I think it'll be a lot better at least. More Solar Blessing playstyles next patch. Good. Totemic Ward. Increase the healing by 50. Or that's actually Spirit's Domain. I still think that's going to still be really bad. 800's not enough. It still ain't. They need to buff that at least up to 900. I think that 900 would be a solid place to start. Still going to be pretty bad. Grover. They decreased burst healing, so they decreased his initial heal, but now it has a more of a tick heal over time, because they put that into his base kit pretty much, and then they reworked Deep Roots, so now instead of actually rooting people, it actually creates a healing field around them for 150 every 0.5 seconds for 2.5 seconds, so like what a 500 health healing aura around enemies. So they took one of his best talents, and again, they reworked into something that's going to be pretty much useless. I don't see any use for this at all. I really don't. Unlike the Androxus changes, though, we needed a shift away from Grover playing like utility or like damage, and we needed a. I'm sick of having Grovers on my team that are solo supports and picking Deep Roots. I don't mind this actually, because I'd rather have a Grover on my team that actually fucking heals their team. Instead of playing like a utility or playing like a damage character the entire game. So I'm all for this one. Anything that gets rid of like supports as like full-on damage characters or moves them away from being like damage supports instead of actually healing their team, I'm all for, because we need less of that in the game. Less damage supports, more supports that actually heal their team first and foremost, and then play damage. Inara removed in-air accuracy, some small Genos buffs. They're buffing through time and space because they keep buffing Haven and they keep buffing Retron. So now they got to power creep a lot of the abilities in the game just to match the items, which makes no sense. But here's Kanessa. Here's another rant. Oh my gosh. I mean, those of you guys that wanted Kanessa being nerfed into the ground, you guys got it. You guys gotten Kanessa nerfed into the ground. Everybody that was bitching and complaining and moaning and groaning about Kanessa being broken and being OP, you guys got your wish. They gave her the Strix treatment from 2 years ago. I don't know what to tell you guys. I don't know what to tell you guys. You know, it comes down to really people not knowing how to play flank. I think that's the real problem. People don't want to actually learn how to play the game, and they just want to bitch and complain until something gets nerfed into the ground. I think that's the real problem. They don't actually want to actually learn how to play the game and learn how to check certain champions and certain characters in a game, and they just want to bitch and complain so something gets nerfed into the ground so they don't have to deal with it. So the game's easier and they don't have to play something else. I think that's the real problem. Who's going to be next, guys? Now we got Kanessa nerfed in the ground. Who's the next champion that we all bitch and complain about? Who's going to be the next one? Was it going to be Moji next time? Is Moji going to be the next champion that we all complain that's broken and OP now? Is that going to be the next champion? Who's next to be getting nerfed in the ground after two patches of people just bitching and complaining for no reason? Guys are pathetic. I love the Paladins community and everything, but sometimes y'all are pathetic. You really are. Sniper rifle, reducing the damage, reducing the fully charged time to shoot. That's a Strix type nerf. This nerf right here alone fucking killed Strix. This one nerf right here killed Strix back in like 2 years ago, and he's never recovered. Now they're doing the same thing to Kanessa, along with all his other shit. Goodbye, Kanessa. Goodbye. It was good knowing you. It was good knowing you. Maybe she'll still be good on our good maps, but apart from that, you're never gonna see her play it anymore. Huge player rate dip after next patch. She's going to be one of the least played characters in the game. Small Koga buff for Skewer. Who cares? They're reworking one of his cards. I don't. Doesn't matter. It's still garbage. I don't think it'll do anything to him. Lex. Instead of getting nerfs, instead of actually nerfing Lex, you want to know what they're doing? They're actually giving him a quality of life change. So. You could say that's a buff. I don't know how much of a buff it really would be, though. I think it's just kind of a quality of life change that's should have already been a thing a long time ago. But no Lex nerfs. L. Another L for this patch. We needed Lex nerfs. Still just as busted and just as brain dead. You mark somebody with discovery and you just run at them. There you go. That's how you play Lex. Leon's gonna be crazy next patch. I can tell you right now that she's gonna be fucking crazy. Now you're gonna get your entire cooldowns back on Inheritance just from eliminations. That's gonna be really good. Can't wait to play against that. Lilith, they actually listened to us on Lilith, y'all. They actually increased the range on Blood Hex. There you go. That's the one buff she actually needed. I think Lilith now, after this next patch, it's perfectly balanced. It's crazy. I think she actually might be one of the most balanced supports in the game after this next patch. Domba, they increase the cooldown if you miss from 1.5 up to 2 seconds. Not really much to actually change anything, though. I think he'll still be pretty much the same. We got some Octavia nerfs, but the problem is here that these don't do anything. These nerfs don't do anything. Marksman rifle, yeah, whatever. They reduce the range. They increase the range, but they reduce the damage, so it doesn't do anything. Increase the maximum damage done at max range from 50 to 55%. I can tell you right, guys, right now, like these nerfs do nothing to Octavia. She's not gonna change. It's just gonna be like Salty from last patch. They slightly nerf her, thinking it'll do something, and it doesn't do anything. Gonna be the same thing as like Salty from last patch. She's gonna be the exact same. Nothing will change. Mega Potion got buffed, good. And then you got no knockback when trying to self-apply a potion or heal yourself with a potion launcher. Really cool. I still think Pip's gonna be pretty bad though. He's as a healer, like as a he's a better as like a damage hybrid type support now. You can kind of get away with him now, probably more than ever, like over the last year at least. But I think as a support, he's still gonna be pretty bad. Subservience got reworked. Instead of like a base amount of health, now it's 2% of everybody's maximum health. I still think it's gonna be garbage. I really do. It requires too much teamwork and too much coordination, especially to work with your random loser type players, especially in ranked. It's never gonna work. You're better off just picking any other talent, just doing your own thing, just playing for yourself. Still pretty bad. Ray, constrained. Spirit Link no longer prioritizes allies over enemies. Okay. I don't know what that really changes. And then refreshing break, reduce the scaling. I'm not sure what refreshing break is. Is that her all charge card? That might be her all charge card. So they nerfed her all charge card again. Why? Why? Rey is not even that good to begin with. She's a garbage solo support. The only time you can actually play her and get away with her is on a double support comp. I don't know why they continue to nerf her. Again, scratching your head on why they even changed that. Sand Trap. Some small changes, who cares? Nobody's gonna still play Shaolin. Skye. So they're buffing the range on wrist crossbow, so you don't have to be right in somebody's face to actually do your max damage. Man, I can't wait for that. Can't wait to play against that. Then we got preparation, which is being reworked. So now instead of having a full duration of hidden, it's only 2 seconds, but you get movement speed. And reduce, you get 75% DR and then 20% movement speed during your 2 seconds of hidden. I think that's even gonna be worse. Another talent that got reworked that's actually gonna be worse. You're pretty much ruining and wasting one of your entire abilities for 2 seconds of 75% DR and then 20% movement speed. I don't know how that's even better. I think that's actually worse than what she currently has. They're buffing Strix, guys. Here's the Strix buff we've been wanting. 150 health. Wow. And yet they know how to balance this game. They don't. Strix is still going to be probably the worst character in the game alongside Moji. Tiberius. They're buffing Tiberius's damage, but not really enough to where it actually is going to matter. I still think Tiberius is going to struggle. He's going to be one of those damage champions that just really struggle with everybody having Haven and Veteran. That's his main problem. They don't do anything. These damage numbers buffs by 25 each just are enough. That's not enough. Especially if you're buffing Haven and Veteran the same patch, it's not enough. He's still gonna be pretty bad. Torvald, now it's affected by Guardian, guys. Torvald's affected by Guardian, holy shit. They're increasing the damage on Tyra for whatever reason. Okay. Again, power creep. Just because instead of actually nerfing Veteran and Haven, like they should have, they're buffing it again, and now they're having to power creep a lot of these other characters that have lower types of damage. Same with Viktor. There you go. Fatu, whatever. Who cares? Seven to increase the damage by 200 for 210. I mean, they're buffing automatic stance, and they're buffing burst stance for whatever reason. We can finally kill bombs, guys. We can finally shoot at their bombs. Bombs spawned by dash can now be shot and destroyed. That's all he needed. I think he would actually be balanced and see how where he was after this. They just actually put this into the game. They just give us this quality of life change and then see where he is. I think them, I mean, automatic stance is still garbage, but like buffing burst and then buffing all this other stuff and giving quality of life changes as well. I don't know if that he's still probably going to be really good. I don't think that's enough to actually nerf him. He's still going to be incredibly annoying. And then they're buffing his ult and stuff too. So, Victor, they're giving him some increased damage, then burst mode's getting a buff. Again, power creep. Power creep because of Haven and Veteran. Instead of nerfing those two items, they're buffing them, and then they have to power creep a bunch of certain characters that don't have the, really the most damage to begin with. Vivian buffs. Still gonna be garbage. Still not enough damage. The only time she's actually gonna do damage is when she has an ult. She's kind of just an ult bot, and that's the only time she's actually relevant and actually does anything still. They're nerfing Vora for whatever reason. I don't know why. And then we got some Yaggroth buffs. Good. I'm not even going to talk about these buffs because it's all shit we should have already had. I don't know why they even nerfed her last patch or the last couple patches, anyways. Good. Good. They're buffing Yaggroth. Finally, good. Life Exchange is getting a quality of life buff. So now you get 3 seconds off your shatter if you miss. Similar to Domba. There you go. I don't think it'll make her much better. I was hoping they would get rid of one of her damage talents, but they don't. And then we got Xin, which is all just a bunch of elimination cards that got reworked with that change. So there you go. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. I know kind of a longer patch notes video, but like I said, for like a mid-season patch, there just really is nothing here. This is going to be a really boring patch. It really is. No new champion, no new map. Like so an okay amount of balance changes, but nothing like that's like either super crazy that actually changed the game. I don't know. I really don't know what they're trying to do. And like, you guys are bitching and complaining about having too many champions, but like the champions are the main source of new stuff every patch. Now that we have no new champion, this is what we were afraid of. Not enough content for our next patch, and it's gonna be insanely boring. We'll have about 1 week of actual like everybody being excited, and then after that, I'll go back to being super boring. Especially for me, being a content creator for the game, man, I can't. I'm dreading next patch because I'm gonna have nothing. There's gonna be nothing to stream and nothing to have make content for. It really is. I don't know. And then we're also missing a bunch of balance changes too. No Maeve buffs, no Sati nerfs. There's a no Terminus nerfs. There's a bunch of other shit I'm not thinking of that we didn't get in this balance changes. No Moji buffs, no Moji rework. There's nothing here. They're missing a bunch of balance changes too, and especially for a mid-season patch, there's not nearly enough balance changes for this. I'm sorry. And the most of the balance changes we do get just make no sense. Mainly a lot of the ones that the AOC tried to push through and kind of push through to the balance, and then the ones that are pretty much reworking the items and buffing the items for whatever reason. Mainly Haven and Veteran make no sense. I don't know. There you go, guys. There you guys have it. Let's see if they fix the Nintendo Switch crashing bugs. No, this is all champion stuff. I don't think they did. I'll quickly skim over this. I don't think they did. I don't see anything here. I don't think they did. And they never did. They never did. I'll check this a little bit more. I'll let you guys know, but I don't think they did. I don't think they fixed the Nintendo Switch crashing problems at all. I thought it'll never get fixed. Yeah, they don't even know how to fix the sound bug for their entire game. You think they know how to fix that? I don't know. I'm gonna get out of here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe, share the video, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Thanks for stopping by.